Hello everyone, how are you all? Hope you all good. Welcome to the Daily Current Affairs. Today we celebrate International Day of the Tropics and the theme is the digital divide in the tropics. And we celebrate this day the extraordinary diversity of the tropics while highlighting the unique challenges and opportunities of the tropics face. This is an initiative which is launched by the United Nations to promote the tropical regions of Earth. Next one. Today we also observe National Statistics Day. And we celebrate this day on the birth anniversary of P.C. Mahalanobis. And the theme is End Hunger, Achieve Food Security and Improved Nutrition and Promote Sustainable Agriculture. Here, sustainable agriculture is farming in the sustainable way, which by meeting the society's food and textile needs without compromising the now present ability for current and future generations. And P.C. Mahalanobis is known as the father of Indian statistics. Next one. Justice Shambhunath Srivastava has been appointed as the chairman of IFUNA, Indian Federation of United Nations Association. He is a retired High Court judge of Adilabad. Here, IFUNA is a non-profit organization which is to promote objectives of United Nations and its specialized agencies. Here, Shambhunath Srivastava is a High Court judge of Adilabad. Next one. Dr. Usha Natesan, appointed as the director of National Institute of Technical Teachers Training and Research. Usha Natesan is a professor at Center for Water Resource and also she is also the deputy director of Center for Research in the Anna University. And she take the charge for the 5 years as a director of NITTTR. Next one. Montek Singh Ahluwalia, named as a member of high-level advisory group which is formed by the World Bank and International Monetary Fund. Here, Montek Singh is a former deputy chairman of the Planning Commissioner and he is also the distinguished fellow at the Center for Social and Economic Progress. The head of the World Bank is David Malpass. And the International Monetary Fund is located at Washington. And the head is Kristina Georgieva. Here, high-level advisory group is a sustainable and inclusive recovery and growth. In face of the dual crisis, which is posed by COVID-19 pandemic and the climate change. Next one. K.K. Venugopal was appointed as the Attorney General for India. And the tenure is extended by one more year till June 30, 2022, which means he was again reappointed and extended his period for one more year. For the first time, he was appointed as the Attorney General in the year 2017 for a period of 3 years. And last year also, his tenure is extended to one more year. And for the present year also, he is extended to one more year. And till the June 30, 2022. Next one. Itat Eidwar, is an e-filling portal of income tax appellate tribunal. And this portal is launched by the Union Minister of Law and Justice, Communications and Electronics and IT. And this portal is for filling the appeals of the candidates and filling their documents and the applications and the paper booklets, etc. And the Union Minister of Law and Justice is Ravi Shankar Prasad. This is a portal which is included in the new tax e-filling portal. In starting of the June, the central has launched the new income tax filing portal. And the new portal is developed by the Infosys. Next one, Gujarat's Chief Minister has virtually launched the Agriculture Diversification Scheme. Here, Gujarat Chief Minister is Vijay Rupani. He launched the Agriculture Diversification Scheme virtually. And the aim of this scheme is of making agriculture sustainable and profitable in tribal areas of the state. And the governor is Acharya Devrat. By this scheme, there is about 1.26 lakh farmers are going to benefit in One Bandhu scheme in the 14 districts of Gujarat. Next one. Denmark signs a framework agreement on International Solar Alliance with India. Framework agreement. It is totally as International Solar Alliance Framework Agreement. This is the first country to sign this agreement with India. And the capital of Denmark is Copenhagen and the currency is Danish krone. Next one. YONO, You Only Need One, has crossed 70.5 million downloads and with a registered user base of 37.09 million. YONO is a specialized digital platform for State Bank of India, and it has been moving with a 10 million average daily logins of 10 million. YONO is launched in the year 2017. It is a digital banking platform of State Bank of India. And head of the State Bank of India is Dinesh Khara. Next one. R.K. Sabharwal has been honored with the highest civilian award of Mongolia, the Order of Polar Star. The Order of Polar Star is the highest civilian award in the Mongolia, and it is honored to R.K. Sabharwal. R.K. Sabharwal is the chairman and the managing director of Engineers India Limited, and the capital of Mongolia is Ulaanbaatar, and the currency is Mongolian Tarkrok. And the president, recently Mongolia president is changed, and the president is Ukhan Kurlesak. Next one. All-rounder Anusha Rao has been banned for four years by the NADA, National Anti-Doping Agency. Here Anshula Rao is from the Madhya Pradesh state, and she is banned in failing the doping test. Here NADA, National Anti-Doping Agency, is an organization which promote and it is a communication to the sports, and it is also check the how the players are taking their health, is there any taking their drugs or not. She is the first woman cricketer to get banned for the doping. And the CEO of NADA is Navin Agarwal. Next one. ICC Men's T20 World Cup 2021 to be held in UAE and Oman. Actually, ICC men's T20 World Cup should be hosted in India, but due to the ongoing pandemic reasons, and the schedule is shifted to UAE. And recently, we have also seen that IPL, Indian Premier League, has also shifted to the UAE due to the pandemic which is going on in India. And the International Cricket Council headquarters is at Dubai, and the chairman is Greg Barclay. 2021 World Cup should be hosted by India, by the BCCI, Board of Control for Cricket in India. And the president of BCCI is Saurabh Ganguly. Thank you, everyone. Stay safe and stay strong.